before start my talk, I'd like to talk about myself. My name is Jun Ryo. I'm a professor. I'm working for Chuo University.
In Japan, this is red. Urushiba.
I have one question for you.
My given name.
Does anyone know the
pronunciation is very different.
The name of Chuo University? Do you know Chuo University in Japan? No one knows. very sorry. So, Chuo University is a private university in Tokyo. Here you can see the map of that. You can see the Tokyo metropolitan area. This is the occupied of the area of Tokyo Prefecture. And our university, Chuo University, is located here. So I think all of you understand the meaning of Chuo. Chuo being the center.
Freedom to exit.
Chuo, my university is located in the central of Tokyo. That's why the name. Just kidding. Okay. Today, what I'd like to emphasize is. Visualizing and understanding data is the most powerful tool in recently.
One important
thing that tells us many things
is
why we need to understand the data is to improve our life, the quality of life, QOL.
This is very good.
In order to do so, to make the world better, we have to have the analytical ability to understand data and knowledge of how our society works. And final skill we have to have
is
thinking skill to make good discussion.
Mr. Stolman had
next I'd like to show several examples. Here is a snapshot of
the name
activity of Hachioji City. Hachioji City is a small city in the middle size of city of Tokyo metropolitan area where we where our university is located.
Some important person in the Korea.
They provide several data as an open data. They have opened a couple of pages like this.
But the last question we asked
is provided by private sector.
I do not understand.
Private sector also provides
available for free.
Data
made a lot of money
from their activity. For example, this is the
mobile
geographical statistics.
There is a
is the major carrier in Japan.
They provide
geographical data of the users. Of course, the private individual data. That means who is now calling from where and very sensitive data and
it should be
protected because it's very private data. But they provide the data
very statistics. That is why it is so different because it's so fundamental. The right way to communicate these things.
System work, name, where does my money go?
It's international. It's right.
This website showed the activity.
This is what I wrote.
Showing the, how the money used in the grab the activity
not just for the interest of this, but
as a taxpayer. Yeah. Well, so based on these activities, I'd like to show, I'd like to talk about my our activity from the.
Person who cannot speak Chinese write this and communicate. There's something funny going on here. Now, this ability is strongly related to the reason that so many people around the world can cooperate making good software. Please understand this. Why did this come up? Give me another. How do you say this in Chinese? We call this jizhou in Japanese. It's called surang. Surang, surang. This is very important for education. Do not ask too much rights. So, free software, open source software. Is made by people who do not ask for too much rights. They care about cooperation. They care about education. They want you to do a better job. So that's why the quality is so good. This is another word that maybe comes up to your minds. All right, can I proceed to the next subject? My next subject will be hacker. How do you explain hacker to your friends? See, a hacker is not a person that does bad things. You know that. A hacker is a very talented programmer, a genius, creative person. How do you explain that? How do you explain that? How do you explain that? See, I looked up the etymology, that is the word origin of hacker. And there's an English word called hack. English word hack means use an axe to break wood or ice. See? It sounds destructive. But there's a better way to explain this. You ever know this story? All this story? This person best embodies the hacker spirit. Why does he do a good job? Why? He tells us, you know, the body of the animal has gaps already built into itself. If you cut the animal there, then you do not need strong force. The inexperienced butcher does not know that. So he uses force, and his knife becomes ruined very rapidly. This expert, his knife is always very clean. It's always very sharp because he does not use too much force. And by thus, it is very important to understand your subject, what you're working on. Now,
Please look at these words. If you try to say understand in Chinese, you always use characters that have the sword or the blade. See? You see this? The blade or the sword. The blade radical, the sword radical.
Say that
move to the next subject. Any questions up to now? Okay. Has anybody heard of this story? The person lived around the 3rd century or 4th century. He was a ridiculously stingy person. Stingy person. Wow. By the way, do you know him? Youngest member of seven. So this person had a very nice tree of plums in his house, and every year in the season he sold them. But he did not want people to obtain the seed, so he used a drill to destroy the seed before selling. Strange. How can a person who cannot speak Chinese write this? Very, very strange thing. 지원하세요가 힘이 총수. This one is 후퇴가이규 金水資源 もし枠、事情の心霊の始まりなり C枠、君子は美に悟り、精進は美に悟り We have a traditional way of reading Chinese. It's very important for us because we use these characters. We have to know what they mean and we have to use them correctly. And to do that, we have to study the Chinese. And we actually study the classics. But the people who study the Chinese classics tend to go to other fields, not to software engineering. So we don't have many people who can do both. I'm a very good, rare exception. So, are there any other questions? No questions?
You said that Richard Stallman doesn't like the word open source. How about you personally?
I actually don't like it, and in Chinese, I think that we should, how about this one here? This gratitude, and especially it uses gratitude, that conveys it better. And not only the word open source, but open source is related to some kind of negation of free software, and we tend to ignore the contributions of Richard Stallman. And that sets a very bad example. And because we have to feel gratitude for the people who gave us the good tools to work on.
I think he deserves a Nobel Peace Prize.
Yes, that's.
Yeah. But that's not the world we're in.
So, better still is that is a world in which many people understand what he did. See, if many people understand it, they have no Nobel Prize given to him. If people don't understand, that's not good. Especially we people who use software, we should understand his contribution. That's my opinion. No other questions? Questions? So I have some little gift for you. I have some writing by a Japanese philosopher who lived about 100 years ago, 140 years ago. He was the start of Japan's modernization. He studied Chinese classics. He couldn't speak Chinese, but he could write Chinese. And he wrote some very interesting things about modernization, about accepting Western technology, what was it about. And he said that it's not so different from Chinese philosophy, the ideals of the wise people.